Ever since tractors were invented, farmers have wanted to know which machine was best for them and their farm. The modern farmer has a host of ways of finding out: magazines, advertisements, agricultural shows, and demonstrations. But in the early part of the 20th century, tractors were rare, and the chance to see a lot of them at work at the same time was even rarer. The answer was a tractor trial, and one of the biggest held in this country was the 1930 World Agricultural Tractor Trials, and they were remembered 75 years later with a special event at the 2005 Carrington Rally in Lincolnshire. The 1930 World Trials are often called the Oxford Trials because they were conducted under the auspices of the Institute of Agricultural Engineering at Oxford University, with the support of the Royal Agricultural Society of England. But the event itself took place in and around the town of Wallingford. They weren't the first such trials in Britain, but they were particularly important.
Well, the 30 trials were very important because it was actually the first time that the tractor trials had been held that actually tested the tractors scientifically. There had been a lot of trials previously. In fact, I think the first one was about 1904 Baldock trials, and then we had the Lincoln trials, 1919, 1921. But they were more an evaluation of the tractor as a concept. By 1930, they'd realised that the tractor was actually a viable proposition, and it was actually a machine that was going to be here to stay. So they decided to set up the trials to evaluate each tractor, test each one for drawbar horsepower, they tested them for belt horsepower, they tested them for fuel consumption, and the idea was that the farmer could have the results and then choose his tractor.